All right, so first things first, let's get a force. We're in a forcing mode currently. Now let's go first in permissive mode because it doesn't shut down in a forcing mode as far as I know. So settings force zero and then shut down reboot now. And the left side is the console of this system. So shut down reboot now and it's rebooting. And this goes way fast. I should probably, there's some red stuff in there, as you can see, failed. This is, by the way, customized systemd because the default systemd doesn't work. Now, I'll log in again. I could have just used the console anyways, but I log in again. Now let's just look for AVC denials. I know there are AVC denials. Let's see if I can scope. So for example, here we have systemd as a Linux policy denies access. So we know there should be some AVC denials there because it says so. So I'm going to look at the logs today. There should be AVC denials here, but there aren't. None. Oh, actually, no, those user AVCs are just policy load notifications. So that's one thing. Here it says, systemd says that policy denies access, but there's no AVC denials at all. I could do a journal control, and then since today, and then, for example, grab denied, or something like that. And here we have a lot of shit today where systemd, as a Linux basically denies access, systemd logs it, but there's no AVC denials anywhere. Not dmessage either. If you do dmessage grab I denied, no AVC denials, no, nothing denied. So there's no AVC denials anywhere. Let's go see if there's more. Here, another one. As a Linux denies access. Let's see what we have. It's also failing somewhere. Let's see what we have. It's somewhere it's red and then something is failing. And this is the load. The booting up is in a forcing mode, by the way. So, here, filter. Oh, this is not related, but it's also something. Let's see what this shit is all about. Where is it loading policy? We have filter listen on the dev init control. Basically, here you have the SE Linux stuff. So we know that I'm lacking some security classes, or at least I'm not lacking security classes, I'm lacking access factor permissions for the system security class. We know that because I know that because I written the policy and I excluded them on purpose because that's not proper and that shouldn't be added the way it is. Anyways, so the unknown permission functionality should tell me, okay, systemd needs, for example, the system shutdown or the system reboot or whatever permission, but you don't have it in policy, and you by default specified that you will deny unknown permissions, so I'm going to deny them. That message, maybe you know that message that you get on boot when you have when you load a policy that's lacking permissions or object classes. That message isn't here, so I don't know that I'm lacking access factor permissions or security classes. I don't know which ones, and for me it doesn't matter because I know because I've written the policy. I know that I'm lacking it. But if you're troubleshooting this, if you can shut down your system, let me just show you that. So here it all the way down. Where am I here? So here's the console. I'll do setting force one. And I'll try to shut down reboot now. Yeah? Where's my console? Here. So basically, we have it. We're trying to shut down, but you can't shut down because as Linux policy denies access. So it's just hanging here. It's not shutting down. But there's no AVC denials. It's not logging AVC denials. It doesn't tell me you're lacking the permission, your policy lacking the permissions to shut down. You're just in a big black hole there. There's no information for you. You can't debug it. You know as Linux is blocking something because it works in enforcing mode, in permissive mode, but not in enforcing mode. There's no AVC denials. So let me just destroy this. Because it's hanging there now. So let's just first destroy. What is it? Silk test network 3. And then let's just first start it again. And then first console. And it's booting up again. So, okay, so it hung on shutdown earlier. Okay, look at a lot of red shit there. As the Linux policy is denying access again. So, but at least it boots. So it hung. So we should have AVC denial. We should have some information somewhere. So again, sudo shell. And basically the password. And then basically our search again. There should be something somewhere. AVC denials. Because we know it hung. It no. Here, user AVC. No AVC denials at all today. Let's see journal control since today. Grep denied. Should be AVC denials. Well, we know that systemd is access denied, but there's no AVC denials anywhere. D message grep denied. Grep I denied. Nothing. So there's just no friggin' way to troubleshoot this for someone who doesn't know the policy. So these are all just normal audit D messages. Let's see that big red stuff here. Here's some systemd listed. Started loading kernel. This is all red. I'm not sure why this is all red, but anyway, so that's the main issue. If you are lacking access factor permissions or security classes, then I should have a message on boot that says this requires these permissions and your policy doesn't have support for those permissions. You said in this case, deny unknown permissions. So these permissions that you don't have in your policy will be denied. Where is that message? It's not there. The functionality is not working, that unknown permission functionality. Well, if that functionality is working, that part is working, but the other part isn't working. It's the part where it should basically show me that and show me what I decided to do on when unknown permissions are encountered. It's nowhere there. There's no AVC denials. There's no way to troubleshoot this. I know that Linux is blocking access because it works in permissive mode, not in enforcing mode. But systemd also spits access denied messages. There's no AVC denials, nowhere to be found. There's just nothing. So that's why I'm saying with systemd, SE Linux is not a flexible mandatory access control. It's a mandatory access control, but a flexible, you can dump that out of the window because it's no longer flexible. It's just that. So that's it.